Okay, Pablo, if you're gonna be in here, you have to relax. Have a rest. But not there, have a rest over there.
My dog is wearing a cone and he is dangerously close to knocking over my equipment right now. Jesus. I really shouldn't be letting him do this. Conehead. I don't know how to be a YouTuber anymore. Okay.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all having a lovely day so far. I am really hoping that the lighting and everything here is gonna work because I'm kind of just trying something new today. We're in my office. Welcome. Welcome to my computer. Welcome to my lamp. I don't know. I really wanted to start doing some more regular content, so I thought the best way to do that is to do like a monthly favorite sort of thing. I used to do them all the time back in the day. And I know now my favorite thing to do when I listen to podcasts is to like hear their weekly wrap-ups of like what they're watching and their recommendations. So this is gonna be a little bit of a like recommendations, things I loved throughout the month. I know that I'm like a few days late, but you know what the hell, every month I go to do this and then it's a few days late and then I'm like, well, it's too late now. It's not too late now, you're getting it now. Let's pretend it's the first. Also, we're going beyond beauty. I'm gonna be telling you the books I'm reading, I'm gonna tell you the shows I'm watching. We're gonna start with beauty because like, you know, it's the heart and soul of my channel. So anyway, here we are, February favorites, February things I loved, the February love list. So fresh, the hits of February. Okay, so the very first thing I have on my list, I don't actually have physically on me because I threw it out. Well done. So over the last year, I've had this major hair discovery transformation. Basically, I discovered over the past year that if you don't style your hair, like at all, it will grow long and it will get healthy. So I haven't gotten my hair done at the salon for over a year now. If you can tell, I'm slowly going brunette. This is like, that much of my hair is my natural color. I have also discovered my dream product, the best shampoo and conditioner I have ever used in my life, hands down. It is top rank, top tier shampoo hierarchy, 100% recommend, and it is Olaplex. If you hadn't already guessed, I feel like Olaplex is really having a moment during this pandemic. Everyone's sort of like looking to themselves and self-care. Basically, it just made my hair feel super healthy, so much stronger. It was obviously a process over time, but after using it for probably about 5 months, I was like, wow, my hair is like a different person's hair. Anyway, if you are someone who suffers with dry hair, you have split ends, you just want your hair to be a bit healthier, I would 100% recommend Olaplex to everyone. Even though it was very expensive, like the most expensive shampoo conditioner I've ever bought, it lasted me so long. Like, because it was so expensive, I was using like tiny, tiny bits, and you only need the smallest amount. All of the products that I'm mentioning in this video are listed in the description down below. I'll have where you can find them in the US, in the UK, and in Australia. So have a look down there to find the links. Yeah, Olaplex is top tier god level. Next up, I want to talk about some skincare that I have recently been trying. I discovered this via TikTok, which seems to be like the new way to discover skincare. I've actually lately been having a whole new issue with my skin that I've never had before, and it is called perioral dermatitis. I've never had dermatitis on my face before. Actually, I don't think I've had any form of like eczema or dermatitis since I was a kid. But it decided to rear its ugly head all over my chin and all around my nose, and it was just out of control. Then the doctor gave me a cream and it got 10 times worse when I put the cream on. It's actually looking pretty good at the moment, and I am putting that down to the products I've been using. I've really sort of reevaluated my skincare. I've been making sure that every single product I use has sensitive skin on it and it is dermatologically tested. Two products that I've been using mostly at night, I've been using rosehip oil, which is supposed to be very good for dermatitis, as it is anti-inflammatory, but CeraVe, I don't really know how to say the name. Once again, these were purchases that I made on my own. This is the hydrating cleanser for normal to dry skin. And this one is the CeraVe moisturizing cream for dry to very dry skin. The issue with the dermatitis is it makes my skin so dry and crusty. So I've been trying to keep my skin as moisturized as physically possible. But yeah, it has been clearing up. The doctor said it would probably take up to 3 months to clear it up completely, but it has been like way better since I've been using these, so I'm gonna put it down to that.
So you guys are probably aware by now, I am super pale. This is me with fake tan on. I wear sun protection every single day. I'm covered in moles. And this is the one I want to recommend. It is the Ultraviolet SPF 50 Plus Screen, Queen Screen, lightweight sunscreen. Feels just like a serum on your skin. What I love about this is it's actually for your face and it just feels like a makeup base. Often when you put sunscreen on your face can feel oily. It can make your makeup actually slip down and like slide off your face and just not set properly. It honestly just feels like you're putting on a primer before your makeup. It doesn't affect how your makeup stays on. I wear it literally every single day that I'm going out in the sun. It's 50 plus, like that's bloody good. Next up, I have a foundation that I have been using for years. You guys have probably seen me use it so many times, you're sick of me using it, but I've only recently started using it like every day and I'm regretting it so much because it's not the cheapest foundation. I usually like to use a drugstore cheaper end foundation every single day and a more expensive high-end foundation for nights out and on the weekends, but unfortunately I've fallen so in love with this that I've been using it every day. This is the NARS Sheer Glow foundation. It is perfect if you have dry skin like I do. It gives you a really sort of like soft, glowy, it makes my skin feel like I have an Instagram filter on my face. It's medium to high coverage, but it's buildable, so you can choose the level of foundation cover that you want by how much you put on. It's very high coverage if you need it to be, but it still looks super soft and like glowy on your skin, and it just makes your skin actually look like skin, moisturized, fresh skin, which I highly recommend. Definitely use it with the powder in the areas that you are gonna get oily or lose your makeup or foundation usually, but yeah, normal to dry skin, get on it. Next up, we have some nail polishes. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll be very aware because I always like post constantly my nails. It's because I'm proud, okay? That the pandemonium / pandemic, whatever we're calling it these days, actually taught me how to do my nails myself. So I have been using Opalac gel polish. I'll link down below again where you can find them. And the reason I want to show you today, A, I love Opalac polish anyway, but this is the color that I have received the most compliments on ever. So it's called Frosted, and unfortunately you can't purchase it alone. You have to purchase it in the pastels pack, but the other pastels are beautiful too. Anyway, whether or not you get the Opalac ones, I'm really digging the light blue nails, and I've had multiple friends who've gone out and gotten their nails done with a similar color. I just think it's a vibe and I would highly recommend it. Let's get pastel light blue going. Lena Lips, queens of dry lips. This is the Lena Lips 101 Ointment Multi-Purpose Super Balm. If you're looking for something to pop on your lips morning and night to keep them moisturized, I 100% will recommend this to everyone. This is just a simple little recommendation. I love it. My lips used to be dry all the time and I'd always like switch up my products and what I was using on them. I have now used just Lena Lips, I think, for probably like 2 years now, maybe a year and a half. And honestly, my lips are so consistently moisturized. Like, I haven't had an issue of dry lips in a very long time. Okay, it's time for the new sections. Welcome to what I'm watching and what I'm reading. I have two shows that I am recommending. I pretty much watch everything that anyone ever recommends. I am a film student. I love film and television, and I just consume all of it. But at the moment, I am guilty pleasure binging on Sex and the City. I can't be the only person who never watched Sex and the City. I feel like Sex and the City is having like a real like resurgence at the moment, and it's like all my age, the younger Gen Ys that are watching it, because we're suddenly like creeping on 30 and like the dating scene, and like it's just so relevant now. I feel like it wasn't relevant before. It wasn't relevant to me. It's still not really that relevant to me, but it's relevant to all my friends, and it's just fun because it's like a similar sort of like vibe to what I talk to my friends about. It's just fun to watch these girls like live their best life and have all these relatable problems. It's kind of like the Dolly Doctor for like 25 to 40 year olds, I would say. So if you're looking for it, all seasons of Sex and the City are available on Binge in Australia. I've been loving Binge. If you haven't checked out Binge yet, get Binge. It's like everything that I'm ever looking for to watch at the moment has been on Binge. It's getting watched more than Netflix. It's getting watched more than Disney Plus. It's getting watched more than Amazon Prime. Yes, I have them all. The second show I've been watching is WandaVision. It is on Disney Plus, and to be honest, the first episode was a bit weird. If you guys aren't aware, WandaVision is like the first series of the Marvel TV shows. You know how Star Wars had Mandalorian? Now Marvel is doing WandaVision, which is their first one, and it's actually so good. But the first episode was a bit tricky to get through. I was kind of like, what the F is going on? I'm very confused. And by third episode, you're like, you're totally in. And now I'm so hooked on it, and I am obsessed with Wanda. I want her hair. I love Vision. Who's been messing up everything? WandaVision. I feel like none of this would be an issue if Tony Stark was still with us. He would have sorted that shit out. Finally, I have book recommendations. I only have one, but there are three. I only have the final book here because I lent the other two to a friend who is reading them as well. This is A Discovery of Witches. You may have seen there is a, I think it's on Amazon Prime, or actually no, it might be on Binge. Binge is so good. There is a TV show called A Discovery of Witches, and it's got Teresa Palmer in it, and she is beautiful and amazing, and I love her. And that's what got me into this, right? I was like, oh, this is a book. I should probably check it out. Basically, if you were the type of person who loved Harry Potter, Twilight, Hunger Games, like that whole vibe, but you're now a grown-up like me, and you want to start reading characters who are your age, actual adults, dealing with adult things at the same time as, you know, being in a fantasy world with witches and vampires and all of the above. Anyway, if you were the Twilight gal, if you were the Harry Potter gal, the Hunger Games gal, this is the book for you. It's so good. This is the third one. The first book was great. The second book was greater. The third was a bit slow, but oh, there's time travel, there's witches, there's spells, there's just, ugh, it's very good. I have really been getting into reading lately, and I've kind of just been reading everything that's trending, everything that's popular, just like going on Goodreads and checking out what everyone else is reading. And that's fun, but I also just ended up reading a lot of stories about, you know, human stories and very realistic things like normal people and whatnot. But this was like a breath of fresh air, and it reminded me of why I used to love reading as a kid, because you could just totally escape to a whole new world. Just so good. It was just really fun to escape to a world that was full of fantasy. If you're in lockdown or trying to stay indoors with the pandemic still, highly recommend. Like, you can get through these so quickly. Like, they're huge. Look how big that is. But literally, I was reading these in like 3 days each. So good. Anyway, I think that is everything. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys stuck it to the end. I hope you enjoyed the new setup. I kind of like just sitting here and chatting to you. It just feels a bit more personal. Yeah, I hope you guys have a lovely rest of your week, and I will see you guys hopefully soon with another video. Let's be honest, I can't make promises anymore. I'll see you when I see you.